Are you telling me we're on?
We're on.
I'm Fran Dunphy, Temple men's basketball coach, and you are watching the award-winning Temple Owls Update.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, roll it.
Two, one.
Rolex. Take it. Ready, full screen. We're gonna dissolve to it.
Steve here.
I wish I had my snack.
About the roll on these bulls out here in West Mississippi.
They defeated the Golden Bears by a final score of 18-3. Once again.
Zach, most people know me in the sports media world here. Someone that looks at the glass half full. And I'm going to continue and just say I have a full water bottle, baby. I'm going with a score of 20-13. That's a little bit higher for some people. What I think is going to happen is there's going to be two touchdowns, one to Robbie Anderson and one to one of the other receivers. Maybe it's John Christopher opening up. Maybe it's Adonis Jennings. Maybe it's Ramon Deloach. But I think those are going to be two passing touchdowns that we did not even see seem possible last year against Penn State. So I'm looking at a 20-13. Temple University is going to be winning for the first time in 74 years against the Penn State Nittany Lions.
Wow, big bold prediction from Tommy Sladak. I will go on the opposite end of things. I'm going to actually agree with Chris Law, though I did bet that cheesesteak. I will say Penn State's going to win the football game by a score of 21-17, and the difference is going to be Penn State's defensive line. They'll get to P.J. Walker just a little bit more than Temple's defensive line will be able to get to Christian Hackenberg. It's going to be a close game. But Penn State is the more experienced team. Penn State is a team that has been there and done that for the last 74 years. So I think the trend will continue, and Temple will lose a close one at the link.
OwlSports update. Rolling in.
Damn straight.
Can I say?
Step drop. Hackenberg's getting the call in the pocket. And he is going to be taken down by Tyler Medikevich. The icing on the cake. The game is over. 74. No more. For the first time in 74 years, the Temple Owls have defeated the Nittany Lions of Penn State. Temple, and we have beat Penn State.
It was a historic day at Lincoln Financial Field. Okay.
3, 2, 1. Down 3, heading into the locker room, the Owls defense came back out and immediately put pressure on Penn State's quarterback as well as the
actor. Does key roll sound okay?
Okay.
74, no more. South Philadelphia was on fire as the Temple Owls took down the Nittany Lions with a final score of 24-10 for the first time since 1941. Coming off this historic win, the Owls look to head to Cincinnati.
I don't like it.
All right, see you.
And we're live.
It was a historic day at Lincoln Financial Field, and the players in... Hold on. Temple defense.
Phew.
The Owls had 10 sacks tonight, this game.
sport by accident.
Is that silly?
If I made friends, I'd make the social butterfly I am.
Yeah, hey, you seem like such an extrovert, you.
Social butterfly. I'm
on. Yeah.
What's up, Nick?
Yo, what's up, man?
What are we doing today?
We are heading up to play University of Massachusetts today. Beat their behinds and hopefully be ranked Monday morning. We'll see.
That's the goal.
Jar, Nick.
Special teams saves the day, and the Temple Owls are 3-0.
The Philadelphia Inquirer's Mark Narducci will be joining us in the studio to talk some Temple football. Owl Sports Update starts right now.
Get your vanilla chocolate sundae with peanuts today. Where'd Rocco at, man?
Temple's defense kept the ball away from the net for the most part, but there's still something really to look forward to with freshman Jordan. Oh, I forgot her name, damn it. Almost had it perfect. All right.
6-0 and bowl eligible on October 17th? Yeah, you heard that right. We'll have complete coverage of the UCF game, and we'll look forward to tonight's game against ECU. Owl Sports Update is live, and it starts right now.
Ready? I feel like I have to shout. I feel like I have to shout because of the fan. Am I good? Are my levels good if I talk like this? All right, okay. Ready? 3, 2, 1. November 13th will be a battle between two of the top five most historic men's basketball programs in Division I.
This is a world premiere. This is a world premiere.
I done been through a whole lot. Trial, tribulation, but I know God. Satan wanna put me in a bow tie.
Pray that the holy water don't go dry. Yeah, yeah. As I look around me, so many motherfuckers wanna tell me, but an amigo never drown me. In front of a dirty double mirror, they found me, and I love myself.
What's going on today is college game day. Starts in about an hour 15. Just waiting on you, Carly Massetti. Coming at you, not live.
Oh my gosh, it's Halloween. I forgot. Whoa. Flower torches.
Well, let the paranoia haunt you. He's the fashion police. I wear my heart on my sleeve. Let the runway start. You know the man's about to love company. What do you want from me and my scars? Everybody lack confidence.
Temple fans, both young and old, came can't.
I'm interrupting the shot. Mind that, mind.
On this gorgeous day of Halloween, thousands packed Independence Hall with excitement and amazing signs. Game day has arrived. The Fighting Irish are in town, and the Temple Owls are ready to take on their biggest game in program history.
On a corner and a line full of fiend and a bottle full of lean and a model on a scheme, yeah. These days of frustration keep y'all on tuck in rotation. I duck these cold faces, post up, he fight for fun.
I forget what they call it, but it's the same with the Rob Snoop mix.
You gotta go to Silky good. Smooth, Rob Snoop. He's Temple Chef. This is the man you want to go to for tailgate food. I recommend it for everyone. That's a K-12.
On a weekend filled with costumes, college game day, and whatever else the hell you said.
Oh my God, that's quite not
possibly,
one. Take me the goddamn
quite possibly Bill Cosby. Nobody actually remembers. Temple decided to play Notre Dame with the Lincoln. Guess what? It was pretty close.
Yeah, okay.
See, does that make you feel better?
It does make you feel better. Two, one.
After a couple busy days spent at the Naval Academy, it's really quiet.
The Temple Owls found production from three new faces against the number one team ranked in the nation. That's right, the freshmen. The three freshmen played a major impact against the number one UNC Tar Heels. I was gonna say tonight. Let it roll, redo it.
Ooh.
Money.
Can you face it towards me real quick? Oh God. Why didn't you tell me that's what I look like?
I thought it was okay.
I'm getting off the bench. I'm an essential player coming off the bench. 3, 2, 1. The Owls are back on the... What was I saying? Owls are... Oh God.
What was the final score? All right, I'm going to do one without the score. Tell me in a minute. With a win over Fairleigh Dickinson, the Owls have broke even on their record. Have broke even on their record. Does that sound right?
I think you said that before. It sounds
good. Okay.
Hello and welcome to this Matt Rule Weekly. Oh, no. Is it OwlSports?
Yeah.
Game report?
OwlSports update. Okay. It's only the last regular season game of the year.
Yeah.
Matt Rule's team. 3, 2, 1. Matt Rule's team.
In 2014, Temple failed. Okay.
I give you no. You're not allowed to use this.
Let's do the post.
I will sue you. It's a disclaimer.
I have been crazy, but that's just all right. I have been lonely.
Ha ha ha, I'm Tommy Sladak. I'm going to do my hair real fancy, and Temple's going to have 90 sacks, and they're going to win the game by a score of 403-6. And both of those...
The way they get to six is they're going to have three safeties. That's 2, 4, 6. Who do we appreciate? Temple. Temple. Go Temple. I'm Tommy Sladek. Have a great night.
No, I did it. Hello and welcome to this OwlSports Update Bowl Special Preview. I am Tommy Sladek here in sunny South Florida outside of the West Palm Beach Convention Center. I just put my hand on my hip. That's weird. That's very uncomfortable for everyone. I'm Tommy Sladek outside of West Palm Beach, Florida. It's sunny. It's really nice out here. There's a lot of palm trees. And I think about going in the ocean later on. It should be a good time. That's just fell to the Toledo Rockets by a score of 32-17 in a Boca Raton Bowl here in sunny.
You mind?
Down go the Nittany Lions.
It's not like that. It's. I think I can maybe do it.
You didn't
74.
No more.
For the first time in 74 years, the Temple Owls have done what many people once thought was the unthinkable. Now it is reality. The Temple Owls have defeated the Nittany Lions of Penn State. This is for Steve Joachim. This is for Bruce Arians. This is for Raheem Morton. This is for Dan Klecko. This is for Ben Ott. This is for John Sabino. This is for my mother. This is for my father. And let me just tell you everything. We are Temple, and we have beat Penn State.
It's not a story of winning, it's a story of going the distance and defying the odds.
Temple football's 2015 season compares to that of a Philadelphia legend, the man himself, Rocky Balboa.
We have the story of the season on this TU TV special.
And it starts right now. That was I.
Right now.
Chasing after rainbow.
I felt like it round up from like
somewhere in the sky.
Yeah.
For our sports update, I'm Christy Sergio, and I smell.
Okay. Now, offensively, the Owls went 8-for-18 from the three. Free throw. It's so hard to say free throw. Free throw line. They went.
The Palestra Associates some of Philadelphia's greatest names in basketball history. And on Wednesday night, it went back in time as Temple, LaSalle, Penn, and St. Joe's took part in the Big Five's first doubleheader since 2004. Reporting from the Palestra, I'm Zach DiMedio, Owl Sports Update.
Time this season, the Owls have played a ranked opponent. The first three didn't play well in their favor. However, the last three have had a little bit of a different outcome. They've
Reporting from the Leocora Center, I'm Rob Barciero. This is the Owl Sports Update post-game report. Just moments ago, this court was mobbed with fans after the Owls fans stormed the court after the Temple Owls. Oh my God, how many times am I going to say fucking Temple Owls?
Hi, beautiful.
Hi. Hi. Hold on, I need to look at it again.
Three, two. The four freshmen seem well prepared to take on their first college basketball season, thanks to head coach like Fran. This is gonna take a while. All right.
Hello and welcome into a special OwlSports Update pregame report. I'm Jared Phillips alongside Zach Gelb, and we have a big matchup. The Owls are taking on number one ranked Villanova.
Up my name. How do you up my name?
Because it's a super name.
I'm gonna up Jared Phillips. It's more syllables.
It's an awesome name.
Good evening and welcome to the Owl Sports Upgame post-game report. What did I say? I did not say Owl Sports Upstate.
Yeah, Upgame.
Did I say Upgame?
Yeah.
You also just said Upstate for the record.
Yes. Well, okay.
Oh, okay.
That was a joke.
Oh, was it? Okay. Did I say Upgame? Wow, okay. That's a first, okay. Good evening and welcome to the Owl Sports Update pro...
Protein report?
Pro-scame. Pro-scame.
That's what it sounded like you were about to say.
Something like that. Yeah, I got you. Good evening and welcome to the Owl Sports Up game. Oh, my God. I know. It's the two words. Oh, my God. Wow. Update. Owl Sports Update post-game. Owl Sports Update post-game report.
Nikki Frank has been the head coach of Temple's fencing program for over 40 years. With a resume like that, the girls aren't afraid. I forget what I was going to say.
Broadcast.
Temple's first ever. Damn it!
Hey guys, I'm here at the Philadelphia International Airport about to board a flight down to Orlando for the men's AAC conference tournament. Temple will get to sit back up. Welcome to an Owl Sports Update pregame report alongside Zach Gelb. I'm Jared Phillips. The UF. Oh, no, I missed the part about the ECU. Oh, AAC.
Stop thinking.
Can I talk real quick about how big of a dingus Nick Rochet is? The night before we leave for this trip, his phone breaks. His phone breaks. So all weekend, this kid's got no communication. It's literally. This, my phone, is the only means of communication this kid has with the world. I mean, what a dingus, right?
I have my iPad.
He's got an iPad, so if he's on Wi-Fi, I guess.
Yeah.
I guess.
It worked for you.
And then you got Rocco and Bree, who are just, I mean...
On another planet.
Clueless. Mm-hmm. Just clueless. And then you got Gelb and Zahn. Who are just jerks. They're just mean.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want anything to do with us.
Mm-hmm. They can't even
stand. Basically, I'm down here by myself.
They can't even stand taking the shuttle with us.
You got phoneless Nick Rochet, a couple of idiots, and a couple of assholes, and then me, just fending for myself out here in the wild.
Again, Rocco and Bree are ruining everything. But aside from that, we are having a fantastic time. Thank you, Ben Ott, for letting me borrow your phone and for answering my phone calls through Ayana's phone. Isn't that interesting? Whenever I call Ben on Ben's phone, he never answers. But we were talking to him on Ayana's phone, and he was more reliable than ever.
I know. I found that interesting.
Isn't that interesting? Ben, gotta start answering your phone.
It's absolutely amazing. You have this UConn team every year. They may not be the best team going into their conference tournament, but they just find a way. And they did that yesterday in remarkable fashion, as it was Nolan who hit that. Not Nolan. It was Adams. My bad. Sorry. Ooh. Read it.
Ooh.
In three games against the Huskies this season, the sophomores totaled just 9 points. If he wants to prove that that was an outlier rather than a no. Now the clock ticks. The Temple Owls head back to, hold on. I know when the highlight is.
What's up? I'm gonna call the hotel and see if you can come in.
Why, it's cool.
Because it sucks.
What's up, Jared? How you doing, man?
Jared Phillips, nicest kid on the East Coast.
Best reporter, too. Dress is very nice.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. In a field of 64 teams, the WNIT presents a unique challenge where Temple could have played anyone in the country. Okay.
Sidelines and calling the plays. Glenn Thomas. Sorry. That was being a jackass.
Hello, Temple fans, and welcome to this special Matt Rule Weekly post-game report brought to you by...
We're already done.
Brought to you by Matt Rule.
52 degrees. This ice water. Okay. Yeah, we'll do that again.
Right here on a very windy day, Temple men's and women's tennis team.
I hate this part so much.
The Owls are 6-1 on the season, I think. Have they even played that many games? 6-1 on the season. All right, that's good.
We're out on the Schuylkill River with the Temple women's rowing team.
Every time you point to me, I lose it. Okay, wait, the team is looking.
We'll sing songs that will never get old. We'll be here forever. We'll rule.